everyone. Welcome to episode number 23 of Rush Roundtable. Today we're going to be going through a hypothetical scenario where Rush recorded Feedback 2.0, and we each put together 8 songs, as in the first version of Feedback, the only version of Feedback. We each put together a list of 8 songs that would be our choice for songs that Rush would cover on a hypothetical Feedback 2.0 album. So first we have Patrick. We have another Patrick as a guest today. This is the first time he's on, so he's going to go ahead and introduce himself real quick before we get into the topic.
Awesome. Thanks, guys. Thanks for having me. I'm Patrick. I am from Baltimore, Maryland. I've became a Rush fan actually when I was probably 14, 15 is when I sort of really got into them in a big way. I could always remember for some reason driving to the beach, and my parents would have classic rock radio on. And for whatever reason, driving to the beach, Limelight always came on the radio. And I started to associate that song with actually going to the beach. Don't ask why, just by chance that song would play.
But I like that.
It stuck in my head. When I first found out how to Google song lyrics on the internet, I put in a couple lyrics that I remembered, and it was Limelight by Rush. And ever since, I've just been a huge fan, digging deeper and deeper into their catalog. Seen them twice in Philadelphia, both times. Clockwork Angels tour and R40. Favorite song, of course, Limelight, because I hate to pick just a popular song, but it's what got me into Rush in the first place, so it has a special place in my heart. And then in terms of favorite album, I would have to say Hold Your Fire right now. It kind of changes from time to time, but just too many great songs on that album, and whenever I want to feel like I'm in a good mood, I just put on a couple of those tracks. So
good one.
Awesome. Next, as always, what we do is we tell you a song we're currently hooked on. If there's not a song you're currently hooked on at this moment, just shout out a deeper track, one that perhaps someone hasn't heard in a while or heard ever. So, Pat, if you want to start, go ahead.
Sure. Right now it's been Presto. I, for whatever reason, certain songs appeal to me in certain seasons, and for whatever reason, Presto to me is a very spring song. I think it's the upbeat nature of the song, the tempo, something that just puts a smile on my face, and so that to me is what I've been listening to.
I mean, might it be because yesterday was Easter?
Easter Bunny.
You know, I thought about that, and I didn't want to, it's a little bit more than that, but maybe subconsciously, maybe that did something.
Just
I don't know.
Bunnies.
Yeah, you know.
I say yesterday because today, recording this video is 4/13. So yesterday, the date of this recording was Easter. This won't see our page until probably about a month from now. But, Kate, why don't you go ahead?
Well, I was talking to the other admins in our group chat today, and I was doing dishes when I had my Rush Shuffle on, and I was really enjoying Everyday Glory and Cold Fire. I was having fun singing along with those, and my husband's working from home, so he may have not enjoyed it so much, but I don't really care. I was having fun.
Cold Fire is massively underrated in my opinion.
Oh, yeah.
So, new idea for a roundtable: songs you listen to while doing dishes.
those are my recommendations.
I'm kidding. I don't think that will ever should be.
We'll lose a few fans.
Go with Working Man on that one.
go ahead.
We're just gonna laugh for 10 minutes straight.
It almost happened.
Kira, why don't you go ahead next?
Hi, everyone. Okay, so for the past, 2 weeks, not just week, but 2 weeks, I have been hooked, line, and sinker on Earthshine from Vapor Trails. I forgot how much of a kick-ass song it is. I actually featured it in the last episode. I had to. It is such an underrated Rush song. It is incredible, especially that drama guitar solo at the very beginning, and especially live. So I've been hooked, line, and sinker, so I guess I'm also kind of shouting out to a more underrated Rush song, but it is so awesome. I just love it. Can't stop listening to it.
Yeah, that's one of my favorites ever.
I actually remember when I first was getting into Rush, R30, I had recorded, and I woke up. I had fallen asleep. I was watching it one night. I fell asleep, woke up, and Earthshine was on it. So that song has always resonated to me as like one of the first-ish Rush songs that I kind of got into, which is weird because it's, you know, pretty deep in the catalog, but I don't know. Random, ridiculous story. Chris?
I've been into three. Kira got me into Earthshine again. I can't stop. And for some reason, what was the second one? It'll come back. But
again.
Somebody on Facebook, I don't know who it.
He's been watching too much Joe Biden.
Merry Christmas.
Go ahead.
Terrible, terrible. I lost my train of thought.
On Joe Facebook Biden again.
I'm part of as many Rush pages on Facebook as I can be, and I just see people posting and sharing all day. And I came across a version of The Garden that was just instrumental. I don't know if you guys saw that. But if you get the chance, look at it. And not because I don't want to hear Getty's voice, but it was really nice hearing just the violins and stuff like that on a mellow song of theirs. And I was listening to that all day. It was really nice. If you get the chance, check it out. I don't remember.
You shared that, right? Because I think I then turned around and reshared it because it was great.
Yeah, yeah.
So what was the third? Did you say your third?
Between Sun and Moon, that was it.
Okay. Ooh.
I think someone mentioned it last week or something. Like that.
I think I mentioned this last week too. Last Monday's episode. But it's still stuck with me. I've had it on repeat. This one song, and that's Emotion Detector from Power Window. I think the car solo is absolutely fantastic. Super underrated track. It's a shame it was never played live.
They didn't do it on R40?
Emotion Detector was never played live. It's the one song from Power Window that was never gone live. It's a true shame.
It is.
Really fantastic. all right, cool. So the topic today again was a hypothetical Feedback 2.0 album where Rush would cover 8 more songs, 8 because that's what they did in the first, that's what they did in Feedback, so this hypothetical 2.0 version of Feedback, 8 songs that each one of us chose, and then a little bonus at the end, each of the 5 of us on this will pick a song that we absolutely want on our, you know, roundtable version of this. We're gonna basically compose Feedback 2.0 as a whole. 5 songs, we're each gonna pick one, and then we're gonna decide on the other 3 between the group. So as always, guests first. Patrick, why don't you go ahead and read your list, and of course, guys, if you wanna explain, you know, a couple songs, go ahead.
Oh man, really throwing the new guy into the fire here. that's all right, I'll do it. So I think I started off with Pink Floyd track, Wish You Were Here, just because I love the acoustic version of Resist so much from R30 and Rush and Rio that if there's a song that Alex and Getty could recreate that magic with, I feel like that could be one that they could do that with. And then
I will point this out, Patrick. So this hypothetical would be if Neil was also on. This is not like post his passing, this is just in general.
Right.
So
right.
Yeah, this is like if this was recorded.
It's funny.
Not directing this directly at you. This is just everyone. Yeah. So
it's funny, Pat, because I picked the 2 or 3 songs that I thought, you know, if they did like a Resist again, they could do it this way. So that's funny you said that.
That's the one live song that I'm like, man, I wish I could get that magic in another song live. And then getting into, I saw some Jethro Tull, threw some of that in there. So Locomotive Breath, I thought the tempo and the timing of that song really works well with the band's tempo and timing and being able to jive so well together. You'd have to replace the flute solo with a guitar solo, but whatever. All Along the Watchtower, Jimi Hendrix, I think there's a lot of room for improvisation, which I know Neil was a huge fan of doing that with his fills, and Jimi Hendrix was, of course, the master of improvisational music. I threw in this song by Bad Company, which is one of my absolute favorite Bad Company songs, Electric Land. It's an awesome song. It's got a lot of cool moments for riffs and drum fills in there, kind of a dark horse song. Same thing with Home by the Sea by Genesis. It's a very visual song that kind of evokes some of Neil's songwriting capabilities. And I think it's a good song for Getty's singing style.
Right up Kate's alley.
I love Genesis.
Oh, yeah? Okay, perfect. Wooden Ships by Crosby, Stills, and Nash. You know, Feedback, the original Feedback cover album had a lot of Buffalo Springfield on it. I think there were two or three songs. Obviously, that was Stephen Stills' original band. So I think Wooden Ships has really cool bass sounds in it that Getty could have a lot of fun with. Lots of time shifts, lots of complexity, lots of layers. And then just to close it out, the last two, I thought to pay homage to two bands that have either influenced or been influenced by Rush. Foo Fighters, obviously inducting Rush into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. So Times Like These by Foo Fighters. And Bare Naked Ladies, one of my favorite bands that from the 90s and still kicking. Getty actually inducted those guys into the Canadian Music Hall of Fame.
Oh, no kidding. I didn't know that.
So if you watch the speech that Getty gave, he talked about their adventurous songwriting, their Canadian sense of humor, and the fact that they're all great musicians. So that would be my eight.
Definitely a great band.
Yep.
Awesome. Ladies, Kira?
I guess I'll go first. Okay. I'm pulling up my list. Give me just one second. All right. So in my list, I started off with Rock and Roll by Led Zeppelin. It's one of my all-time favorite Zeppelin songs. Really good song.
Awesome.
Suffragette City by David Bowie. They used to play that when they were teenagers. I'm actually reading the book that we are going to be giving away, Anthem. And in that book, Getty talks a lot about when they were 13, 14, 15, what they used to play. And it was all covers of these really influential rock bands. So that's kind of why I chose some of these songs, including Suffragette City. They used to play that when they were really, really young. This was before John Rutz was part of the band, before they ever recorded an album. This
really?
Is super young. Yeah, it's in the book. That. Another song I decided to choose is Sunshine of Your Love by Eric Clapton. They also used to cover that when they were really young. Let Me Love You by Jeff Beck is a really fantastic song. My dad loves that song, so I kind of did it because of him too. Plus, I got to see Jeff Beck in concert a few years ago, and I really love that song. The Ocean by Led Zeppelin. Spoonful by Cream. You're a Better Man Than I by the Yardbirds. And then Roundabout by Yes.
That was really cool to see Getty play on the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. That was awesome.
Yeah, that's why I chose Roundabout, because I thought because I wanted to give homage to Yes.
Yeah.
But so a lot of these songs are songs that they used to cover when they were really young. So I thought, like, hypothetically, if they wanted to do another cover album like Feedback, they would probably go back to what they used to play when they were first starting out as musicians. I mean, Eric Clapton, David Bowie, Zeppelin, Jeff Beck, Cream, Yardbirds, that's why Getty said in the book, that's why they became musicians, is because of these guys. So I thought hypothetically they'd want to pay more homage. So that's my list.
Nice.
It's a pretty solid list.
I'd say so.
Kate?
Okay. Well, the thought process I went through was, who was influential to them, or who do I know that they're a fan of? And also, songs that I like that I would like to hear Rush's take on. And as Patrick mentioned, some things would need to be switched out. For instance, you know, Jethro Tull, flute, all that. So I have Teacher by Jethro Tull. I Know What I Like in Your Wardrobe by Genesis. Sunshine of Your Love by Cream. Hush by Deep Purple. Magic Bus by The Who. Long Distance Runaround by Yes. One of These Days by Pink Floyd. And Lucky Man by Emerson, Lake, and Palmer.
Great hits. Love all those.
You two both chose Sunshine of Your Love.
I love that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, Kira and Kate?
Yep.
Oh, that's cool.
Chris?
Yeah, well, my thought process was closer to Kate's. Obviously, the driving force behind my songs was Getty's voice, because they could all play any song, but Getty singing Andre Bocelli wouldn't sound right at all. So I thought Steven Tyler and Getty had a similarity. I'm surprised I didn't think of Zeppelin. I don't know why. I mean, I think Rush could pull off any Zeppelin song. And Rush's, I think, well, Neil anyway, was a big fan of Zeppelin and Bonham back when they started. Pink Floyd, I have Young Lust. I thought that would be really cool. The riffs in that would be cool with the Alex's tones on his guitar. Some of these I picked just because I like them and I've been listening to them, and I'd be curious to hear how Rush did them. Probably way different. Some new songs, some old songs. I kind of took the approach of, the first feedback was songs that influenced them when they were younger, and now this feedback point two might be songs throughout the years that they enjoyed that they might want to cover. I pictured like
feedback point two.
Is that what I said? Too much quarantining. Dude Looks Like a Lady by Aerosmith. Young Lust by Pink Floyd. Ain't That Unusual by Goo Goo Dolls. Baba O'Reilly by The Who. I thought would be really cool to see Neil at the end wailing on the snare. Still of the Night by Whitesnake. I really like the riff in that. Never Too Late by 3 Days Grace. Learning to Breathe by Switchfoot. That would be an interesting spin. And Creep by Radiohead is just a song I like. But I wish I could get to hear what Rush would do to these songs. Creatively.
It's interesting because you're the only one that really picked, a chunk of bands that are newer than,
yeah,
that, right? So new. I mean, yeah. Yes, I was gonna say, yeah, the Goo Goo Dolls, 3 Days Grace, Switchfoot, Radiohead. I mean, you picked, yeah, bands that are like post Rush, right? Where a lot of the all the rest of us really picked bands that were either, yeah, before or during Rush's.
More out of curiosity, right? I had fun thinking about what Rush would do to these freaking songs,
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's cool. That's cool that you, took that approach. I mean, the approach that I took was, first I Googled songs that influenced Rush, and it gave me, I think, a list of like 22 songs or something like that. And I picked 3 different songs from that list. And the rest were kind of the similar thought process I took, that Kate took. Songs that, A, I thought Rush potentially would have been influenced by, or B, songs that I think would be cool to see Rush put their own take on. So I started my Feedback 2.0 with Ramble On by Led Zeppelin. That's probably my favorite Led Zeppelin song. And of course, they were called Canadian Led Zeppelin, basically, in their early days. And I have 3 Zeppelin songs on here, and I think I use so much Zeppelin because there was no Zeppelin on Feedback in 2004.
Right.
So, mm-hmm. So 1 is Ramble On, Led Zeppelin. 2 is White Room by Cream. Mm. Of course, they were heavily influenced by Cream, and I think. And I chose that over Sunshine of Your Love mainly because of Alex. I'd love to hear Alex solo the way that you hear in White Room with the wah and all that. For 3, you're probably going to laugh at me, but I chose Flaming Youth by Kiss. and before I get into this, I want to just point out that Kira's hairstyle reminds me of Gene Simmons. Can you? Yeah, show
no
us.
Shame.
The, there
no
you
shame.
Are. Now just do the tongue thing and then you're all
good. It's asking a little too much.
But so the reason I chose Kiss was because of them touring with Kiss in their early days in 1975, and I thought it would be cool to pay homage to that. And the reason I chose Flaming Youth was because I tried to find something that was not sexual in nature, because I don't see Rush really doing songs like that, and there's quite a few Kiss songs that are like that, so I tried to choose something that was not that bad. 4th was All Along the Watchtower, Jimi Hendrix. This was one, well actually the next 3, this and the next 2 were songs that were in the list of 22 songs that Rush was influenced by, and I think 11 was Alex and 11 was Geddy or something like that, but All Along the Watchtower, Jimi Hendrix. I mean, it seems like everybody and their mother has covered this song over the years. So why not Rush was my thought. I was originally going to go with a different Hendrix song. I was going to go with Spanish Castle Magic. I don't know if you've ever heard that song, but I really like that song. But I just figured All Along the Watchtower was a better option. How Many More Times by Led Zeppelin? I think this song is, I think it sounds very similar to the original Rush album, some of the songs in the original Rush album. And this was also picked by both Alex and Getty on the list that I pulled from Google, so I figured it has to be there. Comfortably Numb by Pink Floyd. I chose this because I'd love to hear Alex play that guitar solo as well on this song. And because Alex chose this song in his list of songs that he was influenced by. Seventh, I chose Riders on the Storm by The Doors. I think the beginning piano keyboard or piano part could be done on a keyboard by Getty. I think it would be pretty interesting to hear. And I would just like to hear their take on that song. And last but certainly not least, I chose Stairway to Heaven by Led Zeppelin. And I chose this because it's a fairly longer song, and Rush is known for long songs. And I think, and also with this, I'd love to hear Alex's take on that solo too. So I think, to me, Stairway to Heaven is the Fly By Night album. Kind of some of the songs on Fly By Night has kind of a Stairway to Heaven vibe, in my opinion. So I think just hearing that would be cool as well. So. I just want to read two other lists here that were done by both our admin, Pat, who had to or wasn't able to come on due to a family emergency or family something that caused him not to be able to come on, and Jerry from the Rush Fancast, he was going to come on, but he wasn't feeling well, so I'm going to read their lists here real quick. So first, with Pat. Pat chose Highway Star, Deep Purple, The Logical Song by Supertramp, Peace of Mind, Boston, Pinball Wizard, The Who, Love is Like Oxygen by Sweet, I don't know how you say it, Tempest Fugit, is that how you say it?
Fugit
by Yes. I'm not too familiar with Yes, so someone's going to
forget about it
in the comments, I'm sure. Comfortably Numb, Pink Floyd, and Kashmir, Led Zeppelin.
I love the Logical Song. Oh my god!
I love
gosh.
That's a Supertramp.
Yeah, they got some really great cool songs.
Like, I mean, top three for me.
Yeah, for sure. Really? I can hear Getty sing that song. Like, I'm just listening to it, I can hear him sing.
Yeah, you're right.
So next, Jerry chose Manic Depression by Jimi Hendrix. Nobody's Fault But Mine, Led Zeppelin. Canary in a Coal Mine, The Police, Gates of Steel by, is it Devo? Okay. Again, I listen to just mostly Rush, so, I mean, forgive me. Bang a Gong by T-Rex, Wheel in the Sky, Journey, and Jumpin' Jack Flash by the Rolling Stones.
Nice.
So next, we're going to get into basically building our group list for Feedback 2.0. So let's each list a song, and we'll do the order, we'll compose the order in a second. So let's each choose a song that we are dead set that we want in our list, and then we'll pick three songs, as a group that we can fill the album out with. So whoever wants to go first, you know, feel free to give me a song that you're dead set on having.
Dude Looks Like a Lady. I'm sticking to it.
That's such an interesting thought.
It is, right? It's so not really I mean, none of these songs to me are Rush. They're so unique and so intrinsically entrancing with their freaking musicianship. But, you know, I think it's a fun song. I think it would be interesting to hear Getty play it. And Alex to me has never written an average solo where you follow the melody and the notes and stuff like that. I think he takes it to a whole nother level that I've never heard anybody else do. And obviously Neil on the drums, same thing. And so I'd be really curious to see what they do to a regular pop rock song like that, you know?
I think to build off of that, Chris, I guess I wanted to say one of the challenges for me doing this whole exercise was, like, it just proves how unique Rush is as a three-piece, because I would start with something like, okay, I need something that I could hear Getty singing, But then I would look at some of the songs that I like from the 70s and 80s from bands like Journey and Kansas and Styx and all those kind of things that kind of have that showmanship. But I couldn't picture Neil writing those lyrics. So it was like, you know, you can get parts of it and parts of other things, but they're such a unique three-piece that it was hard to get all those things to converge. So
yeah, you're right. I mean, I couldn't, obviously there's no comparing Rush. I couldn't imagine. It was interesting enough hearing them do Feedback, even though they pick songs that fit well into their styles. But, you know, I think that, you know, I think Rush could pull anything off, but
yeah, for sure.
You think they could pull off like Tupac or something?
I wouldn't want to hear them pull off Tupac.
I would.
It would be interesting. You're right.
They could pull off some country or something.
Roll the Bones.
Yeah,
that's
exactly.
About as much of a rap as we're getting.
Do we know who did the rap vocals in Roll of the Bones?
It was Getty.
It was Getty. Toned down. They did like a, I guess you could call it a rap. Maybe, I guess it wasn't really a rap, but in You Bet Your Life, there's like this toned down. But I don't know if you guys. It's the next closest thing, I guess, to a rap.
Yeah, you're right.
Other than what was in Roll of
the Bones. The underlying lines. It's
Yeah, exactly.
That's cool.
It kind of reminded me of the George Carlin. He did a bit called Modern Man, and it was all these really long 4 or 5 syllable words strung together, and that's what You Bet Your Life was, which I loved it. That was cool.
So Pat, what are you thinking for your song?
Tough for me. The one, and I didn't think I'd say this when I was making the list, but I'm gonna go with Home by the Sea by Genesis. And it's a little bit deeper of a track, so if you don't know the song, I would encourage you to listen to it. It's a cool song. I don't know, just fills my head with images listening to that song. So.
Kate, how about you?
Gosh. I think Lucky Man by Emerson, Lake and Palmer.
Solid pick.
Yeah. I'm going to go with that.
And what am I going to go with?
Drum roll, please.
Drum roll.
From please. Last episode.
from the giveaway.
Oh, yeah.
This is tough because I like all these. I think I'd have to go with... I really could see Rush covering White Room. So I think...
Interesting.
Like that's one that I could see them doing and choosing, so I think about that.
They didn't do a Zeppelin song on Feedback, did they? No. That's interesting.
What I said White Room Cream.
Yeah, I know. I'm just...
Oh, you're just saying. Okay.
Yeah.
I thought you were having another Biden moment.
another Chris Piazza moment.
All right. but yeah, I could have easily picked any of the Zeppelin songs, and I think we as a group, when we pick three, we have to at least choose one Zeppelin song.
Yeah.
So Kira had to take care of some things right there. So let's pick our three songs now while we and we'll see if Kira can pop back in. But what do you guys think? I mean, so both Pat and myself chose Comfortably Numb, Pink Floyd.
It's a great one.
Both Pat, Admin Pat, Patrick on the chat or on the video now chose Wish You Were Here, Pink Floyd, and he also chose All Along the Watchtower. So did myself. So I mean,
Kira and I both had Sunshine of Your Love.
You did, yeah.
I had a hard time picking a Floyd song, even though I did, because Gilmore's voice is so unique. Mm. I couldn't imagine Getty even attempting to sing remotely.
So what are your thoughts on going with Sunshine of Your Love, All Along the Watchtower, and Comfortably Numb, all three of them, as our three?
Good with that.
That's great with me.
We do need a Zeppelin song, though.
I was thinking that. I love the ocean. I don't know if that's the best choice.
Kira put two Zeppelin songs on there. So
she put the ocean in what?
She put the ocean and she put rock and roll.
Both great.
I mean,
great
with Zeppelin,
songs.
anything is.
Yeah.
You could pick anything, really.
That's a hard one. I would pick the ocean because it's a little more advanced, I think. But
I chose How Many More Times by Led Zeppelin.
That's a great song too.
I actually don't know that one.
Really?
I don't think so.
I Yeah, I had heard it a few times, and I re-listened to it when I read the list, and I thought, wow, this sounds just like 1974 Rush.
Ramble on?
How many more times?
Oh.
I said, this sounds just like a few songs from the original Rush album.
So that's interesting.
And it was picked by both Alex and Getty in this article. So
yeah, you're right. After it gets going, it really does. Yeah.
That's why I chose that. So
the intro to that is the bass, right? And the soft drums, and then it gets into it a bit with the riffs, I think. If I'm remembering it right. How many more times?
What did it sound like to me? I think I'd have to go back and listen to it.
Yeah, I know what you're saying. Hearing it in my head. Cool pick.
But what are your thoughts on a Zeppelin song? What does everyone think? We have to choose a Zeppelin song.
That was all of them?
I think. Well, we have a lot of Zeppelin choices. So we have Ramble On. We have How Many More Times. We have Stairway to Heaven. We have Rock and Roll. We have The Ocean. We have Kashmir. We have Nobody's Fault But Mine.
Mm-hmm. I think The Ocean.
I was going to say The Ocean or How Many More Times, but I would probably pick The Ocean first.
Patrick?
I don't listen to a ton of Zeppelin, believe it or not.
It's been a long time.
I'm not
a
big fan either.
So I'm going to defer to you guys on this one.
Okay. Not even gonna all right. So we got a vote here. So it's basically two against one, though, right? So we'll go with that. Cool. All right. So we got The Ocean, Led Zeppelin. So we pulled that from Kira's list too. So that's cool. So we have White Room, Cream, Lucky Man, and we'll build this into an album here in a second. Like we'll actually pick the track listing or track order. White Room, Cream, Lucky Man, Emerson, Lake and Palmer, Home by the Sea, Genesis, The Ocean, Led Zeppelin, Sunshine of Your Love, Eric Clapton, or Cream, All Along the Watchtower, Jimi Hendrix, Comfortably Numb, Pink Floyd, and Dude Looks Like a Lady, Aerosmith. I think Comfortably Numb should be last.
Yeah, I'd go for that.
Okay.
Maybe the Ocean somewhere in the middle, but
I feel like we should
is Lucky Man, how does that song go?
Yeah, I don't remember that one.
Lucky Man.
Sing the whole thing, Kate.
The guitar. I could see them doing that, like, Resist live style.
Mm. Gotcha.
I think I've heard that a few times.
I'm sure you have.
I can't picture it.
It's great. I'm just not about to sing it. Sorry.
Then rap it, Kate.
I don't think rap ELB.
That's funny.
I'm pulling it up real quick.
It's funny. I was huge on Zeppelin like 10 years ago for like a year.
Okay, yeah, that's what it is. What I thought it was. Okay, so yeah, I would put that somewhere in the middle.
Yeah, I see them doing that like acoustic style, like Getty and Alex. It's not a very drum-heavy song as it is, so.
Mm-hmm. I think I could see, to begin the album, I think the two contenders for me are White Room or Sunshine of Your Love, either one of those.
I was thinking The Ocean, but.
Cool. Oh, yeah. For the first track?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty in your face, you know.
Chris wants it to be Dude Looks Like a Lady.
No, I get why.
That'd be a
that one's the sore thing.
The fact that you picked that is so funny.
That one's the different one out of these picks.
That like throws you off. Like, wait,
yeah,
what?
Yeah, yeah. It'd be.
Can we like take the Aerosmith out and put in Bob O'Reilly by The Who? I mean,
that's fair. That's fair. They love The Who.
I'm saying it.
That's fair. I was being selfish. I was being selfish.
He's just messing with us.
Yeah, that would be cool too.
I feel like it makes more sense. Like, I feel like all these other songs make sense too. Other than that, it's kind of just like I feel like The Kiss makes more sense than that, only because of the fact that they toured with them. Yeah. So,
is there a list anywhere of bands they toured with overall?
I'm sure it's probably out there. Yeah.
I'd like to see that.
Cool. So, Kira's back.
Hey, girl.
Hey.
Oh, there you are.
Everything good?
Yeah, better.
Cool.
So we chose your song for you. We chose The Ocean by Led Zeppelin because we needed a Zeppelin song. And we needed a Zeppelin song. We also chose Sunshine of Your Love because both you and Kate put that on there. So I don't know if you have the spreadsheet open, Kira, but we're starting to put together our list, our final album. We have White Room, Cream, Lucky Man, Emerson, Lake and Palmer, Home by the Sea, Genesis, The Ocean, Led Zeppelin, Sunshine of Your Love, Clapton, All Along the Watchtower, Jimi Hendrix, Comfortably Numb, Pink Floyd, and Bob O'Reilly by The Who. And Comfortably Numb, we've decided to put that last. So we've got 7 more songs to build out Feedback 2.0 track listing. So what do you guys think for the opener? I know you guys said you think a Clapton song, or Cream song, White Room, or Sunshine of Your Love. I said The Ocean.
I think Dude Looks Like a Lady.
He's still hung up on that.
I'm kidding.
That's bonus track material. That doesn't get released until down the line. Oh,
that's album only purchase. You get that.
I forgot to mention this earlier, but I did want to add a bonus track of Hocus Pocus by Focus. Because
oh, that's
be hilarious
so funny.
To hear Getty yodeling.
So, I know like, that song, too. Joke,
but I could see them pulling it off. If
so
anyone
funny.
Else is familiar with that song, it would be hilarious.
I am.
Yeah.
So funny that you picked that. My cousin used to make fun of it.
I think Bob O'Reilly could be first.
That's yeah, what I was
that
saying.
Could.
Mm-hmm. It's the opening track on Who's Next, so. Mm-hmm.
It kind of has that spirit of the radio feel at the beginning that kind of gets you in the mood and sort of sets the tone.
Thinking, yeah.
The heavy jam at the end.
The Ocean kind of had the animate vibe to me, though. That's why I said that.
Mm.
How there's like a little very faint intro that you can hear and then just kind of hits you. But all right, so we'll go with Bob O'Reilly for the opener. I think White Room is perfect for second.
Yeah, I agree.
Sure.
And then maybe we'll go with The Ocean, Led Zeppelin.
Yes, I love that.
Then maybe Home by the Sea, Genesis.
Works, middle track, sure.
So we got 3 more spots. We got 5, 6, and 7. We got Lucky Man, Emerson, Lake and Palmer. We've got Sunshine of Your Love, Clapton, and All Along the Watchtower, Jimi Hendrix. So
I feel like Lucky Man should be like second to last.
I was gonna say that.
I feel like it's got that kind of vibe.
Right before Comfortably Numb?
Yeah.
Yeah. I was thinking Sunshine of Your Love before that, and then All Along the Watchtower 5th.
A lot of people have covered that. You're right. I forget how many.
So here's our – are you guys cool with that?
Yeah.
So here's our final Feedback 2.0 hypothetical. If Rush decided to do another cover album – so we have Baba O'Reilly by The Who. We have White Room by Cream. We have The Ocean by Led Zeppelin. We have Home by the Sea, Genesis. We have All Along the Watchtower, Jimi Hendrix. We have Sunshine of Your Love by Cream. We have Lucky Man, Emerson, Lake, and Palmer. And we have Comfortably Numb by Pink Floyd. Oh. Anything else you guys want to add?
I was just thinking that, and I can't think of much right now.
Other than Hocus Pocus by Focus.
That's the greatest song.
You guys need to listen to it afterwards if you don't know what I'm talking about.
That's the greatest song and band title I've ever heard in my life.
I tell you what I am going to do. I'm going to take everyone's list and make a Spotify playlist and be listening to it for the next 3 or 4 days.
I'm going to explore these songs.
Yeah. Make sure you throw
them. I want to do the same because I don't really know a lot of these songs except for Zeppelin pretty much.
When did you get into Zeppelin, Kira?
Well, as I said in episode 17, I grew up with Rush, but another band that my dad played throughout my whole childhood was Zeppelin. And back when he was a bassist and he had his amp and the guitar caps, he would play, like Rush, Led Zeppelin concert videos, and he would jam out on the bass to them. So I heard a lot of Zeppelin growing up.
Amazing band.
Favorite. I even have a family friend that's in a Led Zeppelin tribute band, and they don't really go around the states. They do more local stuff, but they have traveled to the Dominican Republic. So I've always been a fan, yeah.
I got into Rush and Zeppelin around the same time, so that's interesting.
We could always do you know, a part two to this. Feedback
3.0. Yeah, we could go forever.
You know, we can, because, you know, we could get some different faces too on here, the other admins that couldn't make it tonight. We can get some, you know, just some variety too, and do it again. And
Chris's list will just keep getting weirder.
Yeah, Chris will have some Michael Jackson on there.
Great.
Some Nickelback.
Oh, God.
Listen, I'm the host of this meeting. I have the power to kick you out if you put Nickelback on here.
Nickelbacks don't get me started.
So, yeah. Cool. So, guys, thank you for joining us. And thank you for watching. Please feel free to throw some songs in the comments of this video. Songs that you think Rush could have done really well as covering it, or even compose your own feedback 2.0 in the comments. 8 songs that you think Rush should have or could have done pretty cool as a cover. So again, Patrick, thanks for joining us on this episode. Other admins, talk to you soon, and have a great day or night, everyone. Take care.
Awesome. Bye. Thanks. Bye.